Good afternoon all. My topic for today is clinical outcomes of pars plana versus anterior chamber IMED glaucoma valve for refractive glaucoma. Trabeculectomy has always been a gold standard for controlling intraocular pressure, but in refractory cases, GDDs always play an important role in intraocular pressure control. But the anterior chamber tube placement has got its own problems, like tube corneal endothelial touch, tube erosions at the limbus, and certain cases it's very difficult to place the tube in the anterior chamber due to extensive pass like this. So, as an alternative, pars plana insertion of a GDD into the vitreous cavity was first described in 1991. But is one better than the other one? So we decided to compare the clinical outcomes and the complications of eyes undergoing IMED GDD implantation with pars plana tube placement with eyes which had conventional AC tube implantation. We studied 38 patients from a retrospective study of refractive glaucoma who underwent a PP or an AC tube placement of an IMED glaucoma valve by a single surgeon. So we collected the data from our medical records. And our success criteria was IOP lower than 21 millimeter of mercury and higher than 5 millimeter mercury with or without anti-glaucoma medications, without any additional glaucoma surgery, and without the loss of light perception. We analyzed using various statistical methods. The results being the gender distribution was equal in both the groups. The baseline clinical parameters, preoperative mean BCVA was 1.4 in both the groups, mean IOP recorded was 34 in both the groups, and the number of anti-glaucoma medications were 4 and 3 in anterior chamber and pars plana entry groups. The common indication in our group was neovascular glaucoma followed by silicone oil induced glaucoma. When we compared the outcomes between the two methods after surgery, there was a considerable reduction in preoperative intraocular pressure and the number of postoperative medications. The postoperative vision also was maintained in both the groups. When we compared the success of the implantation, if you see in the first part, in the anterior chamber entry, the qualified success was around 82% and complete success was 9%. Whereas in pars plana entry, qualified was 56% and complete was 6%. We had 4 cases of failure in this group, which amounted to 25%. The complications and the revision surgeries was higher in pars plana group, but which was not statistically significant. When we did the Kaplan-Meier survival curve, we found that around 42.1% and 56.2% at 24 months of anterior and posterior groups respectively. In our group, the common indication was neovascular glaucoma, whereas in the study conducted by Quinn et al., he found around 45.6% had primary open-angle glaucoma. In our study, the overall success, that is complete and qualified, was 90.9% in anterior chamber entry and 62.4% in pars plana entry. And failure was noticed in 25% of pars plana entry cases. This is in contrary to the previous studies by Maris et al., where the success rate was 83.9% in both the groups and failure noted was 16.1% in both the groups. Quinn et al., in a study which was published in Journal of Glaucoma, found an overall success rate of 86% in the pars plana group, comparable to 80.7% in the AC group.
Dr. Deepankar Dash, please be ready with your next presentation.
Our failure cases, we had two patients who had a recurrent plate exposure and one case of blebitis and one patient had no perception of light. Mean IOP and mean number of IOP lowering medications did not differ between the groups at the baseline and after surgery, which is similar to the meta-analysis done by Bin Wang et al. 5 cases of complications occurred in pars plana group and 7 in the AC group. There were no significant differences in the rates of observed complications between the groups, similar to the study by Quinn et al. The difference between the survival curves by Kaplan-Meier survival analysis of the two groups was not statistically significant. So to conclude, pars plana placement of glaucoma drainage devices is as effective as AC placement at lowering IOP, reducing the number of glaucoma medications required, and to maintain light, at least light perception visual acuity in long-term follow-up. But the overall success in pars plana placement group in our study was significantly less when compared to anterior chamber placement. We had our own limitations being a retrospective study with limited number of cases and variability of follow-up times and inability to match cases and controls on characteristics such as previous ocular procedures. And of course, selection bias also might have existed because of the surgeon's preference. So to decide whether to put the tube in the anterior chamber or in the pars plana, we have to individualize each case, and the clinical judgment can be refined by more of large randomized control studies. Thank you.